Good morning. So in this lecture video, I'm going to explain one program, how to analyze the program. I mean, program is given, how to find the operation of the program. Let's consider one simple question appeared in the exam. That is, examine the following code and analyze the result with flop register content. And this is the small program given. Move A1. Now it's actually not A1, it is A. Move A comma hash minus 30. D refers decimal number. So move R2 comma hash minus 50 decimal. So R A comma R2 is a simple program given. So we need to analyze this program. Analyze in the sense what will be the operation. So what is the result with flop register? Let's analyze. See, this is the program given. So what happens after the first instruction executes? As we know, so it is a negative number, it is in decimal. Okay, so it's equivalent hexadecimal in 2's complement number. As you know, negative numbers are represented in 2's complement form. That 2's complement form is copied into accumulator. So we obtain 2's complement of 30. So in as if we are expecting the result, I mean, to perform the operation of minus 30 minus 80, so you are expecting the result minus 80. Let's analyze that. So 30 in decimal it is 0001, I mean 8 bit number, and 4310. So to get a 2's complement, first get its 1's complement. 1's complement is 0010001. Add 1 to this, it becomes 2's complement. 2's complement. So in hexadecimal it is E2H. So after executing the first instruction, A is equal to E2H. Okay. Similarly, equivalent to 2's complement of 50. So 50 in binary it is 0011 0010. It's 1's complement. Add 1 to this and it becomes 2's complement. So 2's complement form is CE. So after executing the second instruction, R2 will be equal to C2H. And in third instruction, R content of A and R2. So now we have A is E2H and R2 is CEH. So let's see in binary. So this is in hexadecimal, it is in binary. So we start addition from the LSB. So 0 plus 0, 0. Next 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. And carry 1, these are the carry bits. Again, 1 plus 1, 0, carry 1. Again, 1 plus 1, 0. Carry 1. So again 1 here 1 plus 1 0 carry 1, and again here 1 and carry 1. Correct. So the result is in hexadecimal it is first 4 bits 1011 means B. Next is 4 zeros 0. So B0, this indicates with a carry. So after execution of this instruction, R A comma R2, A is equal to B0. And carry flag is set to 1. Auxiliary carry flag is set to 1. Because see here the carry from. This is the carry from bit number 3. Or you can say bit from the lower nibble. Hence carry, auxiliary carry flag is set to 1. And parity is set to 1. That means it is a even parity. See the number of 1's in the result. So 1, 2, 3 1's are there. So 3 1's means odd number. So parity flag is set to 1. And we say overflow is set to 0. Because see this is what. Carry into MSB, or we can say carry from bit number 6, and this we say carry from the MSB, or we can say carry from bit 7 C7. So we know the expression for overflow, C7 excludes OR with C6. C7 excludes OR with C6. So 1 excludes OR with 1 is a 0. Hence overflow is a 0. Correct. And that means result is within the range. Now the question is, will this represent minus 80 as we are expecting minus 80? Yes, it representing minus 80. As we know, some correction supposed to be needed. When carry flag is set to 1, the result is negative. So the result is negative. If the result is negative, it is in 2's complement form. Discard the carry and obtain the recomplement the result. Recomplement means again obtain the 2's complement of the result. Now the result is B0. Its 1's complement is 010041. plus 1 to this, okay, it becomes 0101 zeros, and this represent in decimal 80. So B0 represent minus 80. Is it clear now? In 2's complement form. This is a simple program to be analyzed. It is called a reverse engineering. It's called reverse engineering. So we'll see similar program. One more question appeared in the exam. Again, same examine the following code, analyze the result with clock register content. So these are the three instructions given. Again, it is signed operation. They are specified positive. They are specified. MOV A comma ash 96. Nothing is specified here. Nothing is specified means it is decimal. So if it is H, 96 will be copied to 96 will be copied to A. But here in the previous program it is specified D. So decimal. But here it is not specified. So by default they are decimal number. By default they are decimal number. So convert it into hexadecimal. So 96. I mean, as if you are expecting the result, 96 plus 70, 166. Correct? 166. So now see, 90 in hexadecimal it is 60H. It is in binary 0110 and 4 zeros. So after executing the first instruction, and similarly 70 is equivalent to 46 in hexadecimal. So after executing first instruction, A is equal to 60H, and after executing second instruction, R1 is equal to 46H. Clear now? And we know addition. Okay, that means, as I said, microcontroller performs operation in binary. So let's see, it performs addition of 60H plus 46H in hexadecimal, and this is equivalent. So first nibble 6 and next 0. And for the second number, first upper nibble is 4 and then 6. So similar procedure. Start addition from the LSP, so 0, 1, 1, again 0, 0, 1, and here 1 plus 1, 0, carry 1, and it is a carry bit, and this is 1, clear na? So in hexadecimal it is, first 4 bits are A, next 4 bits are 6, so it is A6. So after executing this instruction, A is equal to A6H, and overflow is set to 1, because observe, this is the carry from 6th bit and there is no carry from bit 7. So 0 excludes R with 1 is 1. So overflow expression is C7 excludes R with C6. So C7 is 0, C6 is 1. So 0 excludes R with 1 is 1. So overflow is set to 1. And carry flag is equal to 0, means there is no carry from the MSB. Auxiliary carry is 0, no carry from lower nibble, and parity is equal to 0 because even parity. See the number of ones in the result, 1, 2, 3, 4 ones. So even parity. So parity is set to 0. Now the question is, why overflow is set to 1? Yes, it's supposed to be set because see the result is, expected result is 166. So 166 is not in our the range. So our 8-bit signed range is minus 128 to plus 127. Minus 128 to plus 127. So the result plus 166 is exceeds the range. Then what we supposed to do for that? That is why overflow is set to 1. So here we are expecting the positive result. Correct? So here carry flag is 0, then the result is positive. And overflow is equal to 1, some correction is supposed to be needed. So what's that correction? Complement the sign bit. That means, as if you see the result, MSB is 1. If MSB is 1, it is absolutely negative result. But we are expecting positive result. So complement this sign bit. Complement the sign. So if you complement the sign bit, it becomes just complement the MSB. Okay. It becomes 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. So this represent 38 plus 38. Next question, will this result is right? Yes, it is right, and that means 38 plus 128 is equal to 166. So as I said, now we have, there are 128 positive numbers. If you consider a 0 is a positive number, 0 to 127 means there are 128 positive numbers. In the second round, it becomes, 166 represent 38. 166 represent 38. One another way, the result is right. So 166 is equal to 38. Right? So this is how we analyze the result. Remember, here overflow occurs means we need to complement the sign bit. So we'll continue in the next video. Thank you.